We're a 54-man unit. That's what we are. Unit up for each other.
Hi, everyone, and welcome in once again to GVSU Football Weekly. I'm Steve Lloyd-Jones. The Lakers win it 31-7 here in Pueblo. Grand Valley's now into the national semifinals. Ahead on our program for you today, we're going to look back over this thrilling win with plenty of highlights. You'll hear from head coach Matt Mitchell and some of the players. Our player profile this week is on cornerback Trey Walton, and our special feature is on the road trip out here to Pueblo. It's all ahead on GVSU Football Weekly as we get started right now.
Go Lakers!
Yes, Lakers!
Go Lakers! What the fuck is this?
As we go to first half highlights, Grand Valley begins the game with the ball, and on the very first play, the Lakers get on the board.
It looks like it's a pass formation for the Lakers, and Bart's looking to throw. He's on top to Matt Williams. Matt Williams inside the 10. It's a touchdown on the first play
of
the game.
That's how you want to start the football game. They go deep in Grand Valley. Talking with Coach Mitchell this week, wanted to take advantage of this secondary from Colorado State Pueblo.
Bart Williams is going to hand it to Spencer, and he's got very good room. Spencer outside, breaks a tackle into Thunderwolves territory. Wow. Here, they're going to hand it off. It's a good call by the Lakers. Marty Carter is going to make the first down.
Wow.
Great, great call, third and long. Marty Carter's going to get it here. Tried to step away.
Wow.
Oh, nice run by Carter. Keeps his feet. He's going in for a score.
Wow.
Amazing run. And the Lakers are up two here. 4 minutes into the contest as Marty Carter takes it in for Grand Valley. Long count. Play action. Here comes Judon. He gets there. And
oh,
a big hit,
man,
on the quarterback. I think it was David Talley that got him. Judon blew off that play, though, Bob. Turned the quarterback into the middle. And then the Lakers lower the boom. Grand Valley showing all sorts of people in the box. Are they going after the quarterback? Not as much as you think,
oh,
but no, it's Dylan Carroll who breaks through.
Man.
Bart Williams looking confident right now. He's led his team on two scoring drives. He's looking to go here on first down. He's going over the middle. Oh, what a beautiful catch by Williams. That ball was thrown high. The big body receiver, though, Matt Williams, brings it down for about a 16-yard gain and a Laker first down. What do the Lakers have going here? They're looking to go on top again. They're going over the middle. Oh, what a ball that is.
Wow.
Inside, a laser shot down to Jamie Potts. And Bart Williams, you cannot make a better throw if you're an NFL quarterback. Spencer going to run it on second down. Spins, nice move. He's down close to the 6 or 7. Jamie Potts down to this side. This is going to be Spencer, and Spencer goes into the end zone for the third.
Wow.
Grand Valley touchdown of the first quarter. It looks so easy for Grand Valley right now.
It's unbelievable the way that front five is just blocking and moving guys, and Grand Valley able to throw the ball, protect the quarterback, run the football, anything that they want to do.
I don't think they believe that they can beat Grand Valley through the air, and they're going to, well, they're looking to throw here. They're going to throw it way up in the sky. Trey Walton is out there, and Trey Walton makes the interception for the Lakers inside the 10. Textbook cornerback play. He got inside the receiver, held his position, got nudged a little bit, and still brought it down. I still think we're going to see plenty of Martavius Carter, and he's through the hole. He's got a Laker first down and more.
Great stiff
Marty
arm.
Carter. Oh, what a play by Carter. Great first down run by the Lakers. Bart Williams looking to throw. Matt Williams with the first down reception. Grand Valley, Matt Williams with Bart with a chance to run it. He's going to throw it out here. Matt Williams has got it right on the sideline for a Laker first down. What a player Matt Williams has been.
Bunch formation over here to the right. Watch for a quick out pass here. Take some pressure off of A.J. Thompson. Make a quick throw.
He's got heat coming up the middle. He's in a lot of trouble. That's got to be grounding. He didn't cross the line
of scrimmage. Absolutely it is.
And Matt Judon got hit behind the play and is hurt. Judon will be rolled into by one of his own players, but watch the late hit as he's on the ground. That's just trashy. And the referee looks right at it and doesn't do anything.
How he does not call that is just beyond my comprehension. And
this relationship between Bart and Marty will get better as the game goes on. Ball over the middle.
Nice.
Great catch.
Oh,
another fabulous play by Erston Smith into Thunderwolves territory. Time for Bart. Throws it out here. It's Marty Carter. Marty Carter!
Oh, man.
Oh, what a play. Marty thinking about throwing. Oh, he is throwing. It's out there. It's Potts. It's a touchdown.
Kaiser. Oh, my goodness. What a great job by Kaiser fighting off the double coverage. What a play by Kaiser.
No.
A ball that maybe should not have been thrown. He throws it up for grabs, and Kaiser fighting off two guys comes down with the football.
There seems to be some space on the right side. They're going to run left with Carter. Carter's going to get the first down and more. Carter, oh, he stays on his feet.
Holy cow.
Now it's out again in a face mask at the end.
Yep, we're going to
get the two flags come flying in. This is going to move the ball all the way down near the 15-yard line. 24-yard field goal try. Good snap. Kick is up. Kick is through, and the Lakers move it out to a 31-7 lead. The Lakers on top by 24 here with 20 seconds left to go in the first half in Pueblo, Colorado.
Stay with us. The Lakers up 31-7 at halftime. When we come back, second half highlights for you as GVSU Football Weekly returns in a moment.
I'm so excited for it. The goosebumps.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
Do you like it?
I love it.
If you sign up for DirecTV's latest deal, prepare to be blindsided. Because they'll double your rate before you know it. And you'll find you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you over $3,000. That's why the smart choice is Xfinity. You can see all the best action in football all season long. With no surprises, don't get blindsided by DirecTV. Call 1-800-XFINITY today.
At MetroHealth, we don't see patients, we see people. And when it comes to their healthcare, there's one thing we're all working toward: helping them feel better. Better summers. Better dances. Better retirements. And better roads ahead. This is what we want for every person we see every day. Better. Metro Health. Better all around.
Tell them quit playing with me, man. Tell them quit playing with me.
It's getting ugly. It's getting ugly.
And welcome back. Grand Valley holds a 31-7 lead at the half. As we go to highlights, the Laker defense would now take over.
Sometimes that'd be like a bubble screen situation. They're going to try to throw the ball up the field. Grand Valley's got people there, and it's knocked down. McKissick and the safety carry came over. That's the difference between a throw from this young guy and Bart Williams. And look at the way the Lakers are playing, and this is going to be Marty Carter again. Oh, he's going around the right end, and he's got a lot of room. Great downfield block by Joe Robbins. Carter's into Thunderwolves territory.
Wow. Is that feeling too good
right
now?
We're going to get a good look at it right now. Marquez Goldman coming off from the outside, putting on a huge hit on the wide receiver.
Our Grand Valley showing some heat. Tally's coming. Tally's got him.
Oh, boy. Oh,
and Thompson went down backwards very awkwardly. His leg kind of caved in under him. I hope he's okay. Walton going back. He's just going to lob it up in the air. Grand Valley's got somebody in the area. It's picked off, I believe. The Lakers have it.
Trey Walton once again. Big break for Colorado Pueblo. They're going to let Marty Carter run into the outside.
Oh, look out. Marty Carter, look out! Oh, he's going to go! They're going to bring it back. It's going to be a hold. To the top of the screen out there. One-on-one coverage. Grand Valley's got this played pretty well. The defense makes another big stop at the 14-yard line on Bernard McDonald. This is Dustin Walton, the backup quarterback for CSU Pueblo. Schlosser drops into coverage. They give it to McDonald. McDonald is dropped shy of the first down by, guess who, Marquez Goldman again. Grand Valley running it with Carter here, and he's into the secondary. Carter ran into his own man. He's still going. Carter down inside the 40. Wow. They can't bring him down. Quarterback rolling the right, looking to throw, fires to the end zone. Great play by Brad Horling down there. It'll be fourth and goal. Oh, and they throw it over his head, and that ain't gonna work. And Grand Valley's got the ball, and that is it.
Wow.
The guy that got on that ball was Jacob Howe, recovering that fumble for Grand Valley. Snaps the ball with two. Ollie's gonna keep it himself. Ollie Ajami. Ollie Ajami!
Look at this.
Look out! Hang on, Ollie.
Two hands over that ball when he got to midfield, and a great job of Grand Valley blocking up front.
And the Lakers have done it again, ladies and gentlemen, after beating Ashland to avenge an earlier defeat, and after beating Ferris to avenge a 37-point home loss, they have now taken out last year's national champions.
Oh, it's crazy. You know, we got a shot at two people that beat us this year, and then come out to Colorado and get a win. It's just, you know, You don't necessarily expect this, but, you know, I feel blessed to be in this position.
We had momentum the whole game because of the offense. Like I said, the 21 points that they put on the board in the first quarter, that gave us a ton of confidence. So we were able to go out there and play well.
Could also be a smartphone. And what if that home phone could save you money on your home and wireless bill at the same time? With Xfinity Voice, you get amazing technology like readable voicemail on your smartphone, caller ID on your TV, and even text messaging, all for a low price. Start saving with unlimited nationwide talk and text, and switch to Xfinity Voice for just $19.99 a month for 12 months. Call 1-800-XFINITY today.
Almost done.
Now you can pay your bill, manage your appointments, and check your connection status. Anytime, anywhere.
Oh, so you're protesting? Okay.
Introducing Xfinity My Account, available on any device.
Grand Valley wins at 31-7. They're into the national semifinals. Let's hear from head coach Matt Mitchell.
Well, I think our team, you play GLIAC teams, and we beat those GLIAC teams, and that was good. But we still got some young guys, and they're probably still trying to figure out how good we were. You know, and I was trying to give them confidence. I think that they were looking at Pueblo being the defending national champs and hadn't lost a playoff game, you know, and coming into this thing in the last 2 years. For, you know, our quarterback to hook up with Matt Williams and get that touchdown, I think it, you know, on the sideline, it generated a lot of confidence. You know, I think it provided a lot of momentum, and it was a really big first play to get things going.
Then you put your defense out there, and they stone them, 3-and-out, get the ball back in great field position. You move down the field, Marty, with another great run, and you can just kind of feel the momentum building.
Yeah, you know, and as I referenced at the press conference, I think us having the win in first quarter was huge, you know, huge advantage. You know, I think we felt good about our defense. You know, when you look at, you know, Pueblo's offense, they're not the greatest on third down. And so we felt like if we get stops on first and second down, we get off the field on third down. And when they were backed up, we kept doing that. And then they're trying to punt, and we're getting the ball at midfield. And we got such great field position on both of those next two scores to keep things going. And that was just a credit to our defense getting, you know, I think 3-and-outs or quickly 3-and-outs. And, you know, I would say a little bit I was surprised how well we were running. You know, they're a very stout rush defense. We were kind of getting a hat on a hat. Bart was getting us in some good runs. You know, I think the rushing numbers by Martavius and Bart's pretty humble. Some of that's on him. He was checking the way we were running him, doing some different things that was opening things up. And, you know, that one run we had with Marty, though, I said on the headset, he's just better than them. You know, they had us a little bit in the backfield. He just made a guy miss and outrun everybody.
go 21 zip. However, on that play, Kirk Spencer probably out for the year with a broken leg. You kind of feel it, the momentum kind of exhale there.
Yeah, it was tough. You know, we scored a touchdown up 21-0. Everybody's excited, and I think, you know, Spencer even himself was excited. Started getting back, and he goes down. And initially, a lot of times with injuries, you think one thing, and then it's another. They went out there, and what the doctor was starting to feel it, you could tell it was a broken leg.
You guys really brought the pressure today, put their quarterback under a lot of duress.
That was the game plan. You know, that was the game plan. We weren't going to let him back there and be comfortable. He's a redshirt freshman, and it was a playoff game, and that's what we've been doing lately. You know, and I agree, our defensive coaches, this is who we've become. You know, we get after quarterbacks. We pressure quarterbacks. It wasn't going to change just because of who they were. So I thought we had some really good blitzes schematically designed up from the sideline. There was guys coming free, and you usually don't see it a lot. So schematically, we must have done a good job figuring out a way to attack their protections with some guys, and we were getting in there. And he was slippery a couple times, but we made enough plays to get to some field position.
How's it feel to be 1-4?
Feels good. You know, I think this is a team that's grown quite a bit throughout the course of, you know, the year. And, you know, I give the kids a lot of credit. They never really batted an eye when we lost some games and stuck with it. And we're playing with a lot of confidence right now. You know, I think our defense is a championship caliber defense. I think we have the type of defense that makes things very difficult. And then for us offensively, we got to get healed up. We got some guys banged up offensively. You know, Dotson went out with the deal, and we just got to get banged up. Our offensive line's banged up. We got to get healthy, you know. And so really this week it's going to be critical to get in the training room and get healthy and see what Shepard's got, you know. But like I said, I don't know. Nobody knows, you know. We could be the best team on Saturday. We might not be, but our team's going to have confidence taking the field.
Straight ahead on GVSU Football Weekly, it's our player profile on cornerback Trey Walton. Stay tuned for that. We'll be right back.
My fat head king!
My fat head king!
This is my fat head.
I'm so excited for it. I have goosebumps.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
Do you like it?
I love it.
At Metro Health, we don't see patients. We see people. And when it comes to their health care, there's one thing we're all working toward. Helping them feel better. Better summers. Better dances. Better retirements, and better roads ahead. This is what we want for every person we see every day. Better. Metro Health. Better all around.
You learn something every single day at Grand Valley State University. About who you are, and who you can become. About where you've been, and where you're going. About your goals and how to accomplish them. At the end of the day, you know what you want from life. Find it within yourself. Find it within Grand Valley State University.
As we continue with our program now, it's our player profile segment. Cornerback Trey Walton has been playing great for the Lakers. Two interceptions in this game. Let's find out more about him now.
Well, just taking visits here, seeing the football tradition, the atmosphere here, just the campus. I just really like the campus. I just really loved everything about it when I took a visit up here, so I decided to come here.
Sophomore Trey Walton has emerged as a top cornerback for the GVSU football team. Walton has been making plays all season for the Lakers on the defensive side of the ball. Originally, Walton came to GVSU as a slot receiver and had to transition to the other side of the ball.
I was okay with it as long as I can do whatever I can to help the team out. That's all. That's what it's really all about. It doesn't matter what position I play, whether it's special teams or offense or defense. I'm just here to help this football team win games.
Becoming a cornerback meant learning and adapting. and the coaches help Walton do just that.
Well, just the approach every day, just whatever the coaches have us doing as far as lifting weights or conditioning or just perfecting your craft, just you have to attack every day. You have to just do your best every day to get better at what you do. Well, my size, I've always been told I was a good size for a corner, and I think I can run pretty good. I think I have good hips and you know everything. I think I have the qualities to be a corner.
As the top cornerback on the team, Walton has been tasked with taking on some of the best receivers in the country.
It feels good. It feels good. I work hard to be his best, to be the best player that I can be. So it feels good that they put me in those tougher positions. When you line up against a receiver, you always have to look at it as a one-on-one drill with the receiver. Ball's coming to him every single play. That's the mindset that you have to have, and you have to just have it in your head that you're not going to let him catch the ball this play.
Walton also made the final play that helped defeat Ferris earlier in the playoffs.
Well, I was 100% sure they were going to throw it to my side, to Jake Lampin, because he's a great player. In my opinion, he's their best receiver. He's a senior, and I knew they were going to depend on him to make a play, and I was going to be the one that had to stop him. So, you know, so I just had to make sure he didn't catch the ball.
Trey has been happy with the Laker football team as they have made the playoff run here in 2015.
I just feel like we have really good chemistry. We all work hard. We all work hard to perfect our craft, you know. Everybody's so engaged. Everybody takes the right approach every single day. And I think that's how we got this far into the playoffs so far. So hopefully if we keep doing this, we'll be able to make it all the way.
For today's Laker Lightning Round, we have sophomore wide receiver Erston Smith. Erston, you ready for this?
Yep.
Favorite part of fall camp?
Seeing everybody back.
First car you ever drove?
Red minivan.
Do you have a celebrity crush? And if so, who is it?
Gabrielle Union.
Best dancer on the team?
Duna.
Favorite movie?
Blindside.
Best singer on the team?
Trey.
Favorite breakfast meal?
Pancakes, sausage, bacon, eggs.
Do you get up early or sleep in?
Sleep in.
Favorite thing to do outside of football?
Play video games.
Best nickname on the team and who has it?
Scooter. Yeah.
One thing you always hear from Coach Mitchell?
Run.
Hardest hitter on the team?
Quiz.
Favorite TV show?
ESPN SportsCenter.
Best dresser on the team?
Me.
Worst dresser?
Chaz Lumpkin.
Favorite food?
Pizza.
Best moment at Grand Valley so far?
My ESPN top 10 catch.
Best part about playing football at Grand Valley State?
Tradition.
Player on the team most like you?
Marquez Goldman.
And we'd be remiss if we didn't ask you, how was it to have your touchdown catch at Fair State as the SportsCenter top 10 plays of the day?
Oh, it was great. Something I dreamed of ever since I was a little kid, so it was good to see it.
And for today's Laker Lightning Round, that was Erston Smith. Thanks, Erston.
Oh, you're welcome.
Stay with us here on GVSU Football Weekly. Coming up next, it's our feature on the trip to Colorado. That's coming up next as we return in a moment.
Going. Nice to meet you guys. I have these two laptops. We're going to each download a TV show. I'm going to download it on Xfinity, and you guys are going to download it with AT&T UVerse, and we're going to see who goes faster. Go.
Well, this is a no-brainer so far.
How's AT&T doing?
Struggling.
I'm ready to go. We'll wait for you guys.
Looks like we're going to be waiting for a while.
Don't let UVerse slow you down. Upgrade to an Xfinity X1 Triple Play from Comcast and save when you bundle. See for yourself. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit Comcast.com today.
At MetroHealth, we don't see patients, we see people. And when it comes to their healthcare, there's one thing we're all working toward, helping them feel better. Better summers, better dances, better retirements, and better roads ahead. This is what we want for every person we see every day. Better. Metro Health. Better all around.
And welcome back. Thanks for watching GVSU Football Weekly. I'm Steve Lloyd-Jones. Our special feature this week is on the trip out here to Colorado. Let's take a behind-the-scenes look at how the Lakers got here to Pueblo.
With a playoff game in Colorado, the Lakers knew they would have extensive travels in order to get out to the game in Pueblo. The travel started well on Thursday night as the team was sent off by fans and the band on the way to the airport. Having a charter plane helped the football team heading into this playoff game.
Yeah, it was nice. Obviously, getting a charter jet was, it's a big deal for us. It takes a lot of the bad stuff out of travel. You know, the bus rides, the long bus rides. We didn't have to do any of that. So, just hopping on a jet and flying out here 2 hours wasn't too bad.
It was amazing. You know, that's a good thing about going to Grand Valley. You get to do nice things like this. You know, they fly us out a day early. It was a great flight. Got some nice cookies.
Once the team arrived at the airport, they had to go through mandatory screenings before boarding the plane. Some players waited on the bus to avoid the wind before getting checked by airport security. But once on the plane, the players were ready for takeoff and spent their time watching movies, listening to music, or sleeping. Once the Lakers arrived in Colorado, there was a new task: to adjust to the elevation.
Dang, that was close.
Yeah, I mean, the air's thinner out here. It's a drier climate. You know, just getting your body used to what we're going to be playing in is big. Anytime you can acclimate yourself to the environment that you're going to play in for as long as you can, you know, especially when you're not at home, that's an advantage to us.
I'm putting the blockers on.
Hater blocker.
Getting out here early, yeah, that's a big key, you know, trying to get acclimated to the elevation. It's not that bad right now, but guess we'll see you on Saturday.
The Lakers started the day early on Friday, heading out to Pueblo West High School for the morning walkthrough. GVSU was locked in as they ran through plays to use against the Thunderwolves. Then on Friday afternoon, the Lakers made their way out to the Thunder Bowl to get acclimated to the CSU Pueblo Stadium. After 45 minutes of stretching and breaking a sweat during the short practice, the Lakers went back to the hotel for more meetings and preparation.
I ain't quite that smooth.
There we go, J-Man.
From there, the players who played at Pueblo in the 2013 playoffs were able to use their past experience to help the rest of the team.
Yeah, 2 years ago, came down here, and it was a close-fought game, but we came out on top, and that was a big experience, you know, to draw from that and be able to help the younger guys and kind of let them know what to expect. Knowing the atmosphere that's gonna be here on Saturday, it's going to be, helpful for us during the game.
Our mentality each week is, you know, we just got to win, you know. Whatever you got to do to win, each play you win. So that's been our mentality since Ashland game. Just whatever it is, just win for your teammates.
So as we end things for this week, the Lakers with the win 31-7 over Pueblo. Grand Valley now into the national semifinals as they head to Shepherd. We'll have highlights for you and reaction from the coaches and players. I'm Steve Lloyd-Jones. Thanks for watching GVSU Football Weekly. Have a great week, everybody.
How's it going? Nice to meet you guys. I have these two laptops. We're gonna each download a TV show. I'm gonna download it on Xfinity, and you guys are gonna download it with AT&T UVerse, and we're gonna see who goes faster. Go.
Well, this is a no-brainer so far.
How's AT&T doing?
Struggling.
I'm ready to go. We'll wait for you guys.
Looks like we're gonna be waiting for a while.
Don't let UVerse slow you down. Upgrade to an Xfinity X1 triple play from Comcast and save when you bundle. See for yourself. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit Comcast.com today.
Really?
really good. You look good.
This is my fat head.
I'm so excited for it. I have goosebumps.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
Do you like it?
I love it.